Hey folks, my name is Andrew with Viking Electronics, and today we are programming the RAD1A for paging. Lots of customers today with legacy paging equipment are discovering they need an adapter to make their paging work. Customers are turning to the RAD1A to bridge the technology gap for analog paging systems. This video covers installing and programming the RAD1A for paging. Before we dive in, make sure and click the subscribe button and share this video. If you have any questions or tips after the video is over, please leave a comment down below. All right, let's dive in. Connect the paging source to the phone line input on the RAD1A with an RJ11 jack. The RAD1A screw terminals pins 1 and 2 output 600 ohm audio to the paging amplifier. The RAD1A provides a Form C dry contact for amplifiers that require an external trigger. Pin 5 is normally open, pin 6 is normally closed, and pin 7 is common. Call into the RAD1A's extension or phone number from another line to access its programming menu. The RAD1A answers the incoming call and beeps. Enter *845464, the default security code, to access programming. Change the programming security code by entering a new 6-digit number followed by #47. Add a paging access code to prevent unauthorized paging by typing in a 6-digit number that is different from the programming security code followed by #45. Some paging sources don't provide a disconnect signal. If that's your case, you'll have to use the RAD1A's silence timeout. Tim, one of Viking's senior technicians, wanted you to have this tip. Disconnect from the RAD1A and count the seconds until a busy signal is played back over the paging system. Subtract 1 second for the appropriate silence timeout length. Call back into the RAD1A, enter star followed by your new security code, and program the silence timeout by entering the length in seconds followed by #49. #7 to disconnect. One last important note for applications using zone paging. The RAD1A won't pass touch tones to a zone paging device unless dip switch 1 is set to on. Setting dip switch 1 to on will also disable the paging access code, so if your application does not require zone paging, it's best to leave dip switch 1 set to off. Let me know in the comments section if you still have questions after watching this video. My name's Andrew with Viking Electronics. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.